and get grand finals underway. It's going to be a Wisconsin versus Ohio battle, and definitely not the Ohio representative that most people would have expected.
Oh, yeah.
I'd say almost anyone in the building would have told you Dark Shad would make it to grand finals. And if not Dark Shad, it would have been Colonies, but both of them fell short in third and fourth. And instead, it's going to be Crazy Colors, the relatively unknown Rosalina player, not within his region. Of course,
right.
Everybody knows this guy. You better know this guy.
Oh, yeah.
If you live in the Midwest, if you live in Ohio. But I think this is really him staking a pretty serious claim to being one of the strongest Rosalina players out there.
Right, right. Like, outside the Buzz and Fallen, we have Afro. I'm actually not sure if he still plays. I want to say he dueled with Bayo, but I wasn't sure. You have Afro's very strong. Rosa in the Midwest, as you see, we have Colors. We also have Rayquaza
and Knight.
I was just getting to him too.
Yeah, someone said a couple days ago, I think it was in a stream chat for Civil War or something. Yeah, Midwest has all the Rosas, and then someone goes, no, we only have Rayquaza and Knight. And now Crazy Colors must have seen that comment. He's like, word, bro.
Had to throw his name into the mix.
Yeah.
As he's going up against Marshall here in Grand Finals. Marshall on winner side, so Colors going to do his best to hopefully get this reset.
So you said that you think Colors has this.
Most definitely. He's very familiar with the Diddy matchup. I'm pretty sure he's played Agent in Neo before. He's come out on top. He's played Cincinnati's Diddy Psy. He's come out on top. Also, we have Diddy's all over Ohio. So he definitely knows this matchup. And they've previously met the last time that Colors was able to go to Wisconsin.
Right. So he also does have to take two sets, which might slightly influence things here.
Most definitely. We might see some adaptability out of Marshall. You'll never know in this game.
Yeah, I've definitely been impressed by both of these players today, man. And I don't know. I really don't know how to call this one either way, because Marshall's just been looking so good and so resilient, too. It's like he looked like he was about to drop to Colony so many times, and then actually he was able to squeeze the set out.
Fighting this man.
Also, very similar to the Fox matchup, I feel like Diddy Kong is one of those characters that struggles to put Luma into tumble state, and like his forward air and back air, generally very good moves, actually don't do that to Luma until she's taking quite a bit of damage.
Right, so he has to overextend and pretty much use monkey flip kick or the actual command grab hit if he wants to get rid of Luma. See, right there, actually doing it. Oh my goodness, both hits doing the job.
Oh, he just got absolutely crushed by that. 105% post-hit. And now, here's where you might see Colors start to pull ahead. Rosalina with a stock lead is very dangerous.
And Marshall trying to pull out all the options, try and close out this stock before he takes too much percent.
Goes for the trump, but Colors, that quick reaction, just going to mash jump, make sure he doesn't have to deal with that.
These ledge cancels looking pretty crisp from Marshall. Definitely has to be careful, though. Could put himself in a very bad situation if Colors is to catch on.
Yeah, this max rage on Town and City, no less. He should not be on that platform, but he's actually going to take the stock anyway. Only a 15% deficit. This is certainly doable for Marshall.
Even rocking the four pow pow tag. As I said before, last time he was there, Colors was able to take it over Marshall, but pow pow was able to make sure that he was the one to win the tournament, holding it down for his Wisconsin fam.
Gotcha. So maybe he's trying to channel some of that power from his Sonic Clang brethren.
Okay. Right,
yeah, Marshall just taking care of Luma there. He knows this fight gets so much easier when he doesn't have to deal with her. But also, Colors goes straight into that defense mode play after Luma's eliminated. So, I mean, Diddy Kong, definitely a great character at shutting down other people's offense. His own offense, not too scary. It's not bad at all, don't get me wrong.
Oh, not
Diddy Kong could definitely be aggressive, but you can't pummel this character.
You cannot pummel Rosalina. When will people learn?
It's because he's too much time on the dark arts, man.
Well, then again, Luma was behind him, but still.
Yeah, I think Marshall definitely is just kind of at a disadvantage in terms of matchup knowledge between these two as well.
I can't imagine what roses they have in Wisconsin, actually. I know they just released a PR, and I do not remember seeing any roses there.
Okay, Colors really backed into a corner here. But now that he's got Luma back, it's going to get a little easier. Very Kirihara-esque pivot grab on that monkey flip. That's definitely one of the best ways to deal with that move that's otherwise very scary.
Actually, reading the monkey flip right there, he's waiting for it. He knows if Marshall gets desperate, he's going to go for this punish. And Marshall actually missing Luma.
I love that going on stage, putting Luma into rapid jab immediately. The safe shield pressure from Colors, too, backing up with Marshall. But, I don't know, Marshall definitely off to a solid lead.
At this point, he wants to do his best to Oh, a little overextension there.
Yeah, pressing too many buttons on that shield.
You gotta understand that Colors loves shield, so go for grabs or even go for the roll read. Force the roll out. You gotta go for something. But mainly play safe in this situation, because something like this could cost you the game.
Wow.
When all he needs is an up tilt, goes for an up air, gets Ray Luma at the same time. There's the fair all-stage advantage for Marshall.
I like the attempt. That was very smart. I actually think that's something Diddy Kong players need to start doing a little more, is charging the barrels as an anti-edgeguard attempt on recoveries with no hitboxes. But Color's just not able to make enough of a comeback there. He was definitely going.
Oh, he was definitely working.
But he didn't get the paycheck.
Yeah, slowly but surely, but just couldn't do it fast enough. It was coming down to the wire, but I think Marshall was just able to slow it down a tad bit and get it back in his favor. Definitely can't count Colors out of this. He is riding a ton of momentum. He's gotten an Ohio PR win, two Ohio PR wins slash two Midwest PR wins. He's got that PGR win. Definitely going to be feeling good about that. Now, heading to battlefield, this benefits both characters. Diddy's going to be able to use the platforms just as much as Rosa, but not to the same extent, because they up air usage and juggling. Then again, we've noticed that Colors loves to use the platform, especially when Luma is gone. Like right now, Marshall doing an amazing job dispatching Luma in a short period of time.
Okay, nothing off of that down tilt. Usually you see Diddy Kong players at least able to get a grab and then a couple aerials afterward. But Marshall just kind of taking these piecemeal punishes. Nothing too serious. Oh, and Colors has been blowing up every single one of those monkey flips, man. Not every single one, but I'd say like 50 or higher percent. And that's not a good conversion rate, especially for a move that's that good. So maybe Marshall's going to have to rethink his approach. Oh, of course, as I say that, just gets one right there.
Again, he's going to have to do it. His main goal right now is to get rid of Luma so he can get in.
I'm sorry, did you see how patient Crazy Colors was there? He literally just sat there and waited. Then, after Marshall ran off the edge of the platform for the aerial, Crazy Colors knew. He didn't even try to go for a risky punish. He ran up, blocked it, then got the punish. This guy is really smart, man.
He has the patience of a saint. I have not been able to beat him because he outpatients me. I get too overzealous, and it ends up costing me in the long run.
I'm not going to lie, man. After this Grand Finals, first thing I'm going to do is go challenge him to a money match. or a friendly, at least. I really want to play him.
He'll pick either one. I was actually expecting the side B, the hitting Diddy tech right there, side B to try and catch that recovery, but the up tilt working just fine.
You saw how Luma ate up the banana that Marshall tried to spawn.
Oh, don't air dodge. Oh, wow, actually getting sit in.
That was super lucky on Marshall's part. Hanging on to this first stock still. Just going to run up. Throw that forward air in his face. Pretty much Diddy Kong's forward air beats every single one of Rosalina's moves. However, the one thing it doesn't beat is Luma's existence. Like, it'll clank out all her moves because of the low priority function, but still, just getting delayed with that few extra frames of hit lag is actually a huge pain for her. Or for Diddy Kong, rather.
Right, and we're even seeing that being a pain for when he's trying to monkey flip in. Colors taking Marshall's first stock that way.
Yeah.
Again, he's going to have to be more reserved with the use of monkey flip. As I say that, he's like, I don't care. I'm going to just keep doing it. It'll work eventually. He hasn't, despite losing the stock, he hasn't gotten punished too much for it.
Okay, these short hop double up airs. Of course, pretty much the bread and butter for Rosalina. Definitely your best or most threatening move.
Ooh.
Dangerously close there for Marshall. And actually swinging up air instead of forward air while running off that platform. I feel like that could have totally turned the tides if he had one neutral right there. Wow, I like the ambiguous pressure there, going for a roll.
And still trying to go for it, but gets the ledge trump back air. Definitely fine.
Yeah, it looks like Colors is just picking trajectories that aren't going to get caught by that.
Oh, wow. Surprised Luma didn't actually get knocked off from that. Just respawned in the nick of time for that to work, but no.
Look at Marshall going for the fake out on the trump, too. Like, puts the banana there, gets right up in his face, maybe trying to elicit a roll from Colors, but...
Another monkey flip read.
How did he live that?
We saw Darkshot die at that percent with no rage and Ryu. But hey, I'm not going to question it. It was obviously just better DI than what happened in the Darkshot set.
More than likely, or maybe even the sour spot of the up smash. We even seen that it traded with Luma, knocking Luma away.
Possible. So now we have a 1-1 situation. Colors, man, with a long road ahead of him. He's got to win 5 more games in total.
And definitely.
What's messed up is that he could still win another game, and it doesn't mean anything. You know, Marshall just needs to get it. Only 2 more to win the entire tournament here. I love how he's stuffing him out with Starbiz, which actually has Transcendent Priority. So it's going to beat the Monkey Flip Kick, which normally rips through most moves.
And you've seen him running away. He's trying to react to these Monkey Flips with either the jabs, Starbiz, like you were just saying, or just that pivot grab as well.
Yep. It's looking like Crazy Colors is kind of finding his stride here, figuring this matchup out. But Marshall definitely always brings something new to the table with every single match. He's not getting repetitive in this gameplay at all. That's that years and years of experience at high levels of Smash that are going to allow him to do that.
Another Monkey Flip's going to be able to get rid of Luma. And again, we're going to see Colors stay on that platform. That is his real estate. No Diddy players allowed, but he's still going to try and go for the aggressive. But there's the back throw. Not going to be able to do it.
There we go. Finally, it's actually going to hit. Not even a kill, but I know that means a lot for Marshall just in his head. He's like, okay, I finally got that to work. It's a good sign.
He's really getting away with a lot of these Monkey Flips. Colors has punished him before, but right there, he was actually expecting the ledge cancel, so it really threw him off.
Almost getting dunked into oblivion, but Marshall staying resilient here. Oh, that was actually big trouble, being that Colors still had his jump. You should never go for that if your opponent still has that option. Platform saving Luma, though. If anything, I'm like about to never let Rosalina go to Smashville again just because it's so annoying. Seen it so many times, and now I think 2.5 years later, I'm ready to finally put it down. Like, all right, no more Smashville for Rosa.
Just again, patient play. He's waiting for Luma to come back. Oh my goodness, Whoa. An amazing punish with the dare. Again, just waiting for Luma to come back. He knows he doesn't have to overextend, really. Just wait for Marshall to hang himself with these approach options.
He's definitely been feeling the pain of the extra Luma survivability on Smashville for pretty much the entire duration of this set. Colonies was definitely victim to that as well.
I also hope to see Marshall start grabbing a tad bit more. Every time Luma is gone, he's just waiting to shield. That's all Colors is doing, but Marshall keeps thinking he's going to choose some as shield option, but he's just not biting.
One thing I like about Colors' play, this is something I've only very recently started to notice. People can respond to a relatively safe move on shield with roll as the quote-unquote punish, if nothing else is going to actually punish. So that way you're winning by getting positional advantage rather than hitting your opponent again. And Colors has done that a couple times against the safe aerials from Marshall. I'm really liking that. Plus, Rosalina's roll is actually pretty good, so it works out. Some characters, obviously, like Bayonetta, that would be a terrible idea.
Woo! Oh, goes for the dare there. I was not expecting that. Oh, man, that really caught me off guard. And it caught Colors off guard, too. He's able to close out that stock, not with the dare, but with the up tilt instead. I was looking to even this back up as he continues this onslaught of pressure right now.
I like that for Marshall to turn around Peanut just to keep his pressure going without having to overextend.
Another down throw and reads the air dodge with a back air, maybe a dare situation. Oh, and he tech!
That's that Voldemort skill coming into play. You actually have to be on your point with your edge techs there. And I feel like I don't see a lot of Smash 4 players teching the edge that much.
Oh, not too often, no.
Especially like the Smash DI into the edge and tech. Ooh, gravitational pull though, just causing all kinds of problems for Diddy Kong. Wow.
Amazing. And another dare, catching the barrels.
The timing was ridiculous. That's actually so hard to catch.
Colors looking really strong right now.
Yes, he is. He's on the verge of this bracket reset here. No matter what, we're going to be in it for the long haul. This Grand Finals is not going anywhere anytime soon.
No, not at all. Might see a Game 5 situation. Might see a reset, so stay tuned.
Might see 2 more games. Might see, like, 5 more games. Nobody knows.
Nobody knows, but we'll find out starting here on Dreamland, starting this Game 4 on Dreamland.
Could see as many as 7 more games in this set, by the way. Colors looking really good at the start here. But Marshall just going off on Luma, still unable to kill her. I mean, you play a character like Cloud, for example, two hits, you can get rid of Luma, no problem. Just whatever into dash attack. With Diddy Kong and Fox, etc., they have to do it the hard way.
All right, he had to use the F smash to actually do it, so yeah, that pretty much was a lot to do just to get rid of one measly star.
I don't know what that dash attack was all about. Definitely a misinput of some sort. I think maybe he was trying to do a perfect pivot back down tilt.
Whenever I see Diddy's do dash attack, I just assume it was a mistake.
Pretty bad move overall. Used to be so good in Brawl, too.
His down tilt is his dash attack at this point.
Yeah.
Oh, just barely. Oh, he barely recovers. Oh, my goodness. Had to move around colors there because he didn't have his jump in a very tense situation.
Yeah, these two have very creative recovery patterns. Definitely a fan of how they've been mixing up getting back to the stage.
You gotta, you've seen the barrels from Marshall try and catch colors and him being forced to adjust. Oh, almost catching another monkey flip. He's definitely got to be more reserved with the use.
Oh! The crash landing! Man, that was two of the most infuriating things about Diddy Kong right there. One was the hurtbox shrinkage after monkey flip. It's like, oh, this should be a punish, but it's not because he's so tiny. And then the barrels blowing up, man. Oh, that really grinds my gears.
Most definitely. And I want to see more grabs there. You're seeing that colors is still staying in shield after this, after jabs and fares and everything. There's got to be some point in time where you're just like, okay, I got to grab him. Or even a monkey flip.
We've got the rare Diddy Kong up air kill. That hasn't happened too much since April 15th. Ooh, all that charge, but still wildly unsafe on block. Now Marshall with a chance to get some momentum going here for himself. 40 damage and a dead Luma, I'll certainly take that. And stage control to boot.
Exactly, he even forced the high recovery out of colors, which is something you don't see too often, unless it's out of desperation from the Rosa player. Just trying to get back on stage, definitely not wanting to be edge guarded.
Now I know that Marshall is a fan of Diddy Kong's neutral air, but when he slipped off after the side B edge cancel and got an air, I feel like that was a mistake. He definitely wanted back air, and that mistake could have cost him his life because up air ends a lot slower in the air than back air does. But it doesn't matter. Colors gonna take a stock finally in this match. Almost 3 minutes in.
I'm just wanting to see. I just literally want to see more grabs in the situation. Well, I was about to say before Luma gets back, but Colors just so evasive with his movements in those situations. He's not one to deal with anything Marshall has to dish out. And this is not where you want to be. This is not where you want to be, good sir.
He held him because he wanted to let Luma come back. And be actionable again.
Oh, wow, the banana actually sealing Luma's fate right there. But again, he shouldn't have been trying to fight on that platform. Immediately should have gotten off the platform and just pulled out banana or something else. Because one up throw, that could have been done. That could have made bracket reset.
Such a super intense moment. Now that Luma is back on the field, man, still anybody's game despite the huge gap in percents. And that's going to be a game 5 in set 1 for Marshall.
Not expecting that up tilt to take that stock. Well, actually, not expecting the up tilt when he was trying to land on him. So, caught him off guard for a second there. But we will be seeing a game 5 situation. Is Marshall going to be able to hold it down and get the 3-2? Or is Colors going to be able to reset bracket? It's anyone's game at this point.
All right. Battlefield it is for the 5th match.
3-2.
All right. Let's go ahead and get into it. Again, game 5 situations, you got to pull out all the stops. Anything you might be hiding, you might want to do it now.
Yeah, for sure. Especially if you're Marshall, because if you take this one game, you win the whole tournament. No need for a second set or anything. And also, you get your revenge from that Wisconsin tournament. He beat you at your home, you're going to do the same to him.
All right. That's definitely what he wants right now. He's going in, trying all this aggression, but it's starting to bite him in the butt right now.
Oh, man, and falling out of that jab 3, that could have been, you know, the start of something beautiful for Crazy Colors. But instead, Marshall actually just going to even up the score.
Both at magical percents. And gets F smash, another monkey flip punish.
Rosalina's like, magical percent, only one of us has a wand, baby. I'm winning this.
And he just might. Does not catch him with the back hit. Falling hit a back air, but still.
There's so much end lag on that down smash that Luma was just able to punish him on hit. Again, Rosalina, just all sorts of silly stuff, man. And there we go.
Another one.
Yeah, that anti-air up smash just absolutely devastates Monkey Flip. Got the dash attack. Up tilt tech chase. Crazy Colors building his lead here.
Ooh. Fair. No air dodge coming out from Marshall right there.
Yeah, I like the attempt, you know. Hoping your opponent's scared. But Marshall, again, very seasoned player. Not going to fall for something like that. Goes for the Trump, just trying to sneak something out.
Getting juggled right now. Having trouble landing. Needs to get off this platform.
Oh, man. Eevee, I feel the reset in my bones.
It's, at this point, it just might happen. No jump on Marshall. Oh, never mind.
Wow, okay. Got the actual burner hit of the barrels hitting him away.
Don't monk.
No, yeah, there's no reason to do that. You were safe if you just landed. Oh, and that's it.
There's the recess. Two stock as well. Again, those monkey flips are going to really cost him in the long run. He's got to tone it back, son.
Yeah, for sure. Crazy Colors, though, taking the first set, really showing his prowess in this matchup, too. It's like, Diddy Kong is an amazing character, don't get me wrong, but he just has a couple matchups that, if you're not really fine-tuned in that matchup specifically, it could get bad fast.
Exactly. And as I said before, I can't think of any Rosalinas in the Midwest area, so... Excuse me, the Wisconsin area. So it.
Well, actually, I think Chicago's close enough that he's probably had a few run-ins with Knight, right?
I'd imagine that. Pretty sure. Knowing Knight, he likes to play a ton, so he's probably traveled up and up to Wisconsin, but who knows? But I know right now we're in the set two of Grand Finals. True Grand Finals going on right now.
Yep.
Color's able to reset the bracket 3-2. And now we're seeing Marshall go in right now. He has the advantage, and he's just trying to throw anything he can at Colors. Definitely upset about letting Colors get the reset, but not letting that stop him right now.
And I'm just watching the way that Marshall's dealing with Luma. It's pretty inefficient, honestly. These repeated up tilts or like the multiple pummels, trying to headbutt him headbutt Luma while he grabs Rosalina. It's just not working out so well.
No, just need to go for the immediate grab and next shield. Shield and wait for the Rosalina to call the Luma back, so that way you get away from that scot-free.
Right. But also, you know, granted, he can't do the monkey flip so liberally to get rid of Luma anymore either, because Colors has already shown amazing prowess at dealing with that move.
Exactly. That's pretty much what cost him game 5 of the previous set. And we're seeing less of it right now. Oof.
I'm loving how Colors is playing right now, man. He's just absolutely too clean. But Marshall, man, I still have faith in both of these guys to take this tournament. Second hit of neutral air actually going to keep Crazy Colors safe there. And that's the first stock. Wow, man. Are we going to see him take two? Is he going to win this tournament for losers?
I said he could, and right now he's really shown that he can.
Coming to this tournament, I would have never in a million years bet on Crazy Colors 5 to win it.
Oh, like but you said before, who would expect Colonies and Chad to be out so early?
Right. And at least, like, maybe the number one in some other state's PR, Marshall, could come win it, but nope. It's looking pretty tough. But I don't know. This is still very even, of course. It is a new set. You could see a totally different Marshall. See a totally different Colors. Wow. I'm liking his avoidance of the monkey flip, even though he didn't get a punish there. Still, just getting away from that move in itself is a small victory. There goes Luma this time. No platform to save her. Got the struggle situation. Marshall making the most of it for sure. That's another grab, another 20-ish damage, and then he just gets to pluck his banana and go for it all again.
Right, rapid succession with getting rid of Luma, and now he's still... He's fighting back most definitely. Oh, actually not expecting that dare there. It actually kept Luma at bay for a time that he tried to up smash right there.
And there goes Luma once again. See him trying to clip the vulnerable frames of that recovery with down tilt, but unfortunately, just can't reach him.
And again, we're seeing all these fares, all these down tilts, but no grabs on his shield. You want to see a back throw? No?
Look at that. That's the real difficulty for Diddy Kong, is that forward air doesn't send Luma into tumble immediately. Granted, he did hit him with a couple up airs and then was able to, or up tilts, and then got it done with back airs. So Marshall definitely improving his anti-Luma game throughout the course of these two sets.
And he's going to need it, especially if he does choose to continuously monkey flip like he is, which we've seen less of since this beginning of this match. Ooh, amazing roll read coming out from Colors.
Yeah, loving and that tech chase.
Now Marshall. Oh my goodness, the back air. Catching him dropping shield there.
Man, if only that was the last game.
Oh yeah,
and then this tournament would have been over.
Most definitely, and you know Marshall knows that. Again, we saw a tone down from the use of monkey flip.
Yeah.
And a little bit more aggressive and getting rid of Luma a ton. So you can tell that he's adapted, but at the same time, Colors is adapting just as fast, if not faster.
Yep, well, so far it's 3-3 in games here in this Grand Finals, so it's just about as even as it gets. However, Crazy Colors, Marshall, lucky enough to have come from winner's bracket. Therefore, he was able to drop that one set. Those three games that Colors won, basically, not that they didn't mean anything, but they didn't mean the end of the road for Marshall.
No, not at all. He's given a second chance, his saving grace in this situation, if you will, and he does not want to waste it. Took game one. He's trying to take game two, but right now Colors is fighting back, just staying on him. And all these rolls coming out from both of them.
Wow. That gravitational pull, man. So annoying for Diddy Kong to deal with. I feel like he only gets to use Banana reactively in this matchup, which is really tragic, especially because you can't even do it too effectively when Luma's out.
No, not at all. You have to cast the Rosalina and press some buttons or just not ready, which hasn't happened too often for him. It's so awkward to see that happen as well, just seeing Diddy throw it and it just hit him back in the face.
Yeah. Man, this character, definitely not perfect, even though he is widely regarded as the best.
Again, we're seeing Luma gone and Marshall with all the pressure. Colors trying to get away from him, but on the top platform is not somewhere you want to be.
Yeah, playing a dangerous game there.
And that was very awkward to see Luma actually get hit to the left because that monkey flip literally just got back seconds before that.
Okay, another edge guard situation for Marshall. His down tilt timing has been pretty good, but he's just been unable to connect afterward with a kill move. We saw he actually won the set against Sylvanus with down tilt to forward air at the edge. At a really low percent, too.
Right, but at the same time, Colors has been air dodging out of all of his attempts of doing that.
Yeah, and plus Rosa has no hitbox under recovery, so Marshall could be a little bit more liberal with what he does off the stage.
Yeah, but knowing Colors, he's going to tech. Amazing up smash punish. But yeah, knowing Colors, he's going to tech. I've seen this man tech.
Right.
Ton of stuff. Like, even earlier, he did. It was in doubles. He teched about three times in succession.
We could just hit him out, though, instead.
True.
Just forward air him away. Force him back into that up B. But I don't know, man. Literally the most even game. 11-11. 3-3 in total game counts here. Marshall up in the second set, though. So if he's able to close this one out, it's going to be huge for him.
There you go, going after Luma, gets the back air.
She's not dead.
Not at all.
Not lining up with that little pocket off the edge of the stage. And now Colors all of a sudden looking amazing.
Not punishing that monkey flip. You actually saw him reel back for a second, seeing that it was coming.
Man, these two intensely going at it right now. This is just like, I mean, they're pretty much like equal skill. Like, exactly equal skill.
And that really says something with Colors being number 5 in RPR as well.
Very true. I think that number's going up soon.
Oh, most definitely. And there's another dare.
And these guys are just trading games back and forth. Crazy Colors is actually up 4-3 in total game counts. Unfortunately, he needs to reach that magic 6 number before it's over, though. All right, so now it's basically a best of 3 set to determine the rest of the entire tournament. Whoever wins 2 games first has got it.
And again, it can go either way. Both of these players shown amazing adaptation and punish game. Definitely going to come down to a wire. We might see 10 games out of these two players.
I wouldn't be surprised. I really would not. All depends on how things go in the next few minutes, man. Shuffle 8 about to come to a conclusion, but there's still plenty of sick action before that actually happens.
And it looks like we're heading to Smashville for game 3. 3, 2, 1, go! immediately starting off with that monkey flip, trying to send Luma into tumble as best he can. Shock on that damage, and hopefully he can start another good hit or so. He'll start, Fair will start actually sending Luma into tumble and knocking him away.
And it's actually noteworthy that Diddy Kong's up air sends Luma into tumble at zero, I'm quite sure. Or at least a lot earlier than forward air does.
Which is very awkward.
Yeah, it definitely is, but it could be the opening he needs to start getting rid of Luma in a more efficient way.
And the way he'll definitely catch colors off guard. Who would expect a short hop up air out of Diddy Kong?
Right. I mean, it is pretty good, especially because he can double jump away afterward and it hits while rising, but it's just unconventional. Ooh, the neutral air on landing. Saving colors of skin here. Is he about to do it? No, no way.
No, not high enough. Maybe if that platform was there to give him back his double jump.
Right. Marshall definitely keen to all these up air setups. I don't think I've seen him get janked by it before his time too much.
Again, colors just rolling away, and it's working out for him.
Marshall playing a really, really tight footsies game, just sticking it to colors, but wasn't tight enough. Actually got opened up. Luma's back now, and we have a relatively even match once again. I feel like one of these guys pulls ahead, and then it's right back with a response from the other one.
All right, we might see that right now. He's able to close out the stock. What is Color's response? A down throw? He jumps away. Very good option. You're dodging in that situation. You're eating an up air or a dare in that situation,
yeah,
which is much worse.
We've seen Colors go for a couple dares out of that and actually to immense success. All right, there he goes, hitting Luma, but not enough. You see him trying all of his movement tricks just
really
to try
is.
To chase Luma down.
But there, Luma's gone. He's able to edge cancel, so he's fairly safe.
I'm actually surprised that was the one monkey flip that was possibly the most obvious and also the one that Colors didn't stuff. Wow, that roll definitely called that well in advance, but actually kind of misspaced and mistimed it.
Oh, catches his jump. Is he going to be able to make it back? Just barely. Even catching him with a dare.
Marshall, the master of down air.
Jeez.
That's how he stole that set from Colonies in winners semifinal or winners finals.
Oh, yeah. Was not expecting that. I mean, no, he's been trying to dare colors for the longest and is finally able to land it, putting himself a game up against them. Man, oh, man.
Yeah, this is actually one of the best sets, just period. One of the best two sets, I guess. Two of the best sets.
This whole top eight has been amazing.
It really has been, man. I wasn't sure what to expect because, like, you know, the Michigan and Indiana people didn't end up coming. So I was like, oh, that's kind of a shame. But I'm sure it'll still be fun. And now here I am with possibly one of the most entertaining top eights I've ever seen.
Almost definitely. A lot of people kind of knock Rosa for her slow, boring playstyle, but Colors is keeping us on our toes
with
what he's going to do next.
Yeah, he's not a camper at all. I mean, and even if he was, there's nothing against him.
No, not at all. He's he's defensive, but when he goes in, he goes in.
Right, right. He lets you come to him for the initial exchange, and then he takes it. Like, he hits the ground running from there. So we've got a counterpick to Lilac Cruz, actually.
And a lot of spacing right now. Does not catch him with the monkey flip. Just going to choose to stay right there. But his back is against the wall. And you just see colors. Though not that F smash and jabs. It's just a section. Still, as you said before, colors, that defensive play. He's making Marshall come to him. And he does with that monkey flip. Able to get rid of Luma.
Yeah, I feel like Marshall has consistently been the aggressor throughout this entire set. And Diddy Kong, definitely a character that thrives off of being defensive as well, but he just knows that in that war of attrition, Rosalina does have the advantage, so he kind of has to press forward.
Most definitely, and that's kind of the hard part for Diddy, but it's still doable, most definitely. Oh, wow, amazing monkey flip.
And Luma getting knocked backwards?
Yeah,
what?
I'm not sure why that's the second time that has happened. Definitely no good for Marshall in that sense. He wants to get rid of Luma. If it knocked Luma forward, definitely would have gotten rid of the star, and he would have continued his aggressive onslaught on colors. Right now, still trying to recover and still getting thrown off stage. Able to make it back with that up air, just knocking colors away.
This is such a tight game. Oh, Marshall looking to end this man's career with that down air. That's definitely his signature move. I'd say down air and neutral air are the Marshall.
Right, he uses the most that I've seen out of Diddy players. Well, I actually choose to go to for up air there. Not sure if he meant to do fair or even raw back air in that situation. Either way, if up air had hit, then I'd assume either one of his aerials would hit. Just like that up smash, catching him jumping. Able to take that stock. Jeez.
Man, are we going to see game five? I think we're going to see game
five. I think we are. At this point, it's to be expected. Choosing not to get rid of Luma, instead pulling out the banana.
No, I haven't seen Marshall go even once for the Angel Cortez Z-drop spike at the edge, which I'm just so used to seeing because I play him all the time. But it always throws me off when I see him right up at the edge holding shield with the banana in his hand, and he doesn't do that.
You know, we might see it if he's able to close out this stock. Again, he hasn't gone for it, and at the same time...
What?
And at the same time, Colors loves to jump from ledge, but...
Yeah, exactly. That's like the best way to beat that. Okay, very smart. Marshall's still not getting nervous and falling into the trap of air dodging through those up airs.
He kind of ate that grab, but was hoping to get rid of Luma. Lilat actually working against him in that situation. Oh, wow. Fair after fair after fair. Working out for him. I think this would be a situation to go for the grab, send him off stage, and go for the angel drop.
Yeah, that would definitely be an ace in the hole for him right now. If he's noticing that Colors has a tendency to jump from the edge, so might as well do it. Luma, okay, going the proper direction this time, but actually not enough to kill her. And that downer, not enough to kill Diddy either.
Oh, wow, no monkey flip. He was actually expecting it. That's why he was running away. Amazing, Marshall, amazing. And still not able to get rid of Luma. And up air, not going to be able to do it just yet, despite him being at 144% right now. And there's okay. The up smash, another monkey flipper. Again, we're going to game five. Ten games.
Matches between these two. Mug Life Marshall versus Crazy Colors 5. Again, the grand finals that most people probably didn't expect, but everyone is loving it anyway.
How could you not? Both of these players have just adapted to each other so much. And we're heading to town and city for the end-all be-all right now. Again, Marshall versus Colors. This is game 10. Colors able to reset bracket. Is he going to be able to take this tournament? Pivot grab, immediate up throw, trying to get the pressure going. But Marshall just immediately fares out of that situation. And another monkey flip punish.
Okay, here we go. This is the end of the road. And town and city, too. I mean, couldn't have been a better choice for Crazy Colors. This is probably the most one-sided stage in this matchup.
Right, and he's having trouble landing right now. Marshall's got to find a way to get back on stage. Doesn't choose a monkey flip right there. Good call on his part. Colors definitely not ready for that neutral landing. And now he's got Luma out of the picture.
Let's see if your prediction comes true, man. See if Crazy Colors can win this one from Loser's Bracket. He's certainly on pace to do so right now, but of course it's way too early to call.
That was a very risky down smash from Marshall. He was hoping to get rid of Luma again, but in that situation where you're sitting on that platform and you're at a high percent, definitely don't want to risk it.
I can't believe I'm watching a guy named Crazy Colors 5 win a tournament, by the way. If he wins, we should also give him like a free pass to change his name.
He's not going to. He's never going to drop the 5, just like JT. Not
what? How did that kill?
Rage plus low ceiling working out for Marshall in that situation. He's able to close out that first stock.
Yeah, just as I was saying, the stage is one-sided for Rosalina. Okay, Colors just going to have to peel this stock off, and then we're back to an even game, but Marshall's not going to make it easy for him at all.
Most definitely going to have to get all the percent on him right now before dropping this stock.
Forward throw. I like that, going right into the forward smash to try to knock Luma away, but Colors is able to mash out an up air and clank.
All right, no punish on that monkey flip. Just barely whiffing it.
Well, he just almost died to dash attack, man. I've seen some stuff today that I should not be seeing.
Oh, wow. Trading with Luma again. Definitely not something he wants. He's able to get his feet back on the ground. And another lunar landing. Still not going to be able to do it.
Okay. What?
Still?
What?
And that Luma
that
hit.
That was Luma. Yeah, dude, I swear... Luma, it's just the base knockback that's crazy. When you're very close... what? Okay. Smash 4. Somebody check the the game data. Like,
check the launch rate, please.
Not even the launch rate, man. I'm saying somebody must have hacked this copy of the game. Because all the knockback values are just not what they should be. Oh, he's going to land with that downer to no avail whatsoever. Marshall with a huge lead now. On pace to take Shuffle 8.
Right, he's looking very strong. Color's not able to land, not able to even throw out moves at this point, but he's able to get that jab and at least establish some aggression.
Oh, man, all I'm saying is a couple neutral wins.
Oh, my goodness, this might do it.
Oh, my God. Oh
and
my
he's still
God.
Not letting him land. Marshall on the edge right now.
This is far from over. Oh, no, no, he should have blocked that. Is that it?
He's That's living. Still not in an early pop-off from Marshall.
Yeah, he actually got up and cursed out loud and everything. And
there's a back air, and that's still not going to seal it out.
Wow, he's been like going for that the whole time, too.
I cannot breathe. Up. Almost catching with the back air, immediately getting out of the situation. There's the dash attack. Marshall needs to land, or else it is going to be bad news bears for him.
No.
Is Luma's not going to be able to do it?
Oh, the DI was not right on that back throw. Marshall popping off real loud. Wow, he's got some choice words for the Ohio crowd.
I mean, he's saying that, but who was the random Bayo player who beat him in pools?
You beat him in pools? No, that's hilarious. Solid. Nice.
Free.
Nice.
I'm not saying that to throw shade, but free. And I don't own a Wii U. Come on now.
You don't?
No.
You're going to hit up the military and be like, yo, guys, come on. I served this country. You
I
know?
Wish.
I
got leave on Monday, so I'm actually glad I got to come here. Had the extra money in my pocket. Pleasure to commentate with you. A little shaky there in the beginning, but you know what? I got in the flow of things again, so it was a pleasure.
You were killing it, honestly. No shakiness.
Whew.
All right, so guys, this has been Shuffle 8. Please follow Esports Initiative, ESI underscore OSU on Twitter. Please follow Co-opted Live on Twitter, on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, all that good stuff, man. Hook it up for them. Trying to bring that good stream action to Ohio.
I'll. Nah, I'm spent.
All right, guys. Anyway, we're going to sign off. You can follow me on Twitter at JuiceDoom. You have Twitter, right?
Yes, I do. You can follow me.
I'm going to do that right now.
Senpai Eevee. That's with an N, not an M. Senpai underscore Eevee. Oof. But, man, this is amazing top eight. Definitely not something I expected. Hype matches and amazing players. Again, it's been a pleasure commentating with you, Mr. Max Ketchum.
It has, and I'm about to follow you on Twitter real quick, so there we go. Bam. All right, yo, it's been real, man. Let's get some games.
Most definitely.
All right, take care, everybody. Thanks for watching.